зоне ответственности, в воздушном пространстве США сопровождение осуществляли самолет АВАКС и F-22.
And while the aircraft, the hijacked aircraft, was located in the American airspace, then the American aircraft, the E-3 and the F-22s, were responsible for that aircraft.
Так как самолет направлялся в сторону воздушного пространства Российской Федерации.
But since, of course, the aircraft was going towards the Russian Federation airspace.
Гражданские органы управления воздушным движением проинформировали гражданские органы управления воздушным движением Петропавловска-Камчатского.
The American air traffic controllers then informed the civilian air traffic controllers located in Petropavlovsk-Kamchatsky, which we called PK during the exercise, about the situation.
И также основные командные пункты, находящиеся в Хабаровске и в Colorado Springs, основной командный пункт Colorado Springs сообщил о ситуации на командный пункт Хабаровск.
And then, of course, the main headquarters of NORAD was told about it, and they reported to the main headquarters, which is located in the city of Khabarovsk, Russian side.
Командный пункт Хабаровска, используя внутренние процедуры,
and in Khabarovsk they used internal procedures.
Поставил задачу самолету А-50 и истребителям находиться в готовности к вылету и контролю за угоняемым воздушным судном.
And at that time they gave the A-50, which is the Russian AWACS, to take off and put their fighters on alert.
На границе зоны ответственности США и Российской Федерации пункт БИСАТ.
There was a point in the middle of the ocean called BSAT, at which the responsibility for the target was handed over from the American side to the Russian side.
Происходила передача контроля над угоняемым воздушным судном.
Point they handed over the control over the hijacked aircraft.
Далее по всей территории воздушного пространства Российской Федерации.
And this was given over to the Russian Federation.
Непрерывное сопровождение самолетами А-50.
At that point the A-50 escorted the aircraft.
И истребителями Су-27 и МиГ-31.
And there were fighters, the Su-27 and the MiG-31.
При выходе из воздушного пространства Российской Федерации условно захваченный самолет выключал сквок.
And at the point at which the aircraft left Russian airspace, in other words, when it was landing in Japan, it stopped squawking that hijack code, so that it would no longer show up as a hijacked aircraft.
Для нас, участников учения, это означало окончание первого этапа учения.
And for everybody who was taking part in the exercise, this of course ended the first phase of the exercise.
При втором этапе проведения учения все проводилось в обратную сторону, с тем исключением, что обнаружили, что самолет захвачен Российской Федерацией.
And of course during the second phase of the exercise, everything happened but in reverse, and of course that meant that the Russian Federation recognized the hijacked aircraft first.
И также в пункте БИСАТ но передача контроля над угоняемым судном.
And then at the point in the middle of the ocean, BSAT, control was handed over to the American side.
В пункте БИСАТ по радиоэфиру самолет АВАКС, самолет А-50 вели радиообмен.
And at the point of BSAT, when control was handed over, the A-53 talked over the radio to organize control over the aircraft.
Did the Russian officers agree with Colonel Balf's assessment that it was a big success?
И русские офицеры согласны с тем, что сказал полковник Балф? Учения провелись успешно?
По моему мнению, учения провелись успешно, но окончательную оценку дадут наши руководители в сентябре месяце в Colorado Springs.
Of course, we agree. I agree, rather, that the exercise was very successful, but our will talk about this more in September in Colorado Springs.
A question for both sides: how much exercise costs over and above the regular training expenses that you would incur anyway?
That would be difficult for me to quantify at this time, but what I would say is that we routinely practice this mission, so
In terms of our budgeting for the exercise, we use our normal training funds to do this, and it gives our air crews and our command and control crews great practice in their daily mission. So there were no specific funds set aside for that I'm aware of. If you want further information on that, I can try and get you that information.
Yeah, I'd be interested in knowing, for example, the cost of chartering the Gulf Stream.
Okay.
That would clearly be, I would assume, be a cost over and above the regular training.
We'll try and get that information for you.
The last question I have is, were there any problems or holes, soft spots, gaps that the exercise found that to address?
Слабыми стали проблемы, которые мы обнаружили во время учения. Вот
здесь. Такая тренировка, учение не обошлось без шероховатости.
Of course, just as during any sort of training exercise, you will find some sort of areas that you need to look at a little closer.
Ну, как уже мы выше говорили, окончательная оценка будет проведена с нашими руководителями.
But as we said before, our leadership will be discussing these areas during the September conference in Colorado. And of course, at that time, we will give our evaluation of the exercise.
I would echo my colleagues' comments. I think in September, when our senior leaders get together and we've had a month to digest all the lessons from this exercise, we'll be able to make a better determination. But overall, from my perspective, I saw no major gaps or seams. I think if there's a challenge for us, it will be to take this exercise to the next level, to operationalize it, as it were, to keep these lines of communication open on a 24/7 basis. And obviously, language is a big challenge right there. And that's something we're going to continue to work towards improving.
Okay, if there's anybody out in the outlying areas, the divots or anything that would like to ask any questions, we'll open it to you at this time. I'll take silence as meaning no. Gentlemen, we appreciate you being here for the press conference today. This will conclude it, and if there's any follow-up information, we'll get back with you on that. Thank you.
Thank you. So, that's it.
Good job. Thank you.